Mediterranean Sea in the southern part of Italy. The plants we study belong from two different families of plants called Aliaceae and Brassicaceae, and were collected from three different sites in Sicily. For example, Brassica campestris was collected in Alimena, Allium subhirsutum in Petrolia Soprana, and Allium commutatum in Gioiosa Marea. From this sort of graphical abstract, you can see that their extracts, in particular their ethanoic extracts, were tested as corrosion inhibitors of Corten steel, in particular in acidic environment mimicking acidic strains, and also in sodium chloride mimicking seawater in the case of Brassica. Why did we choose Corten steel? Well, Corten steel is a weathering steel mainly used for outdoor applications and used for in modern art and architecture, as you can see from the picture, but also for building infrastructures. Why? Because it has excellent mechanical and structural properties, and it has also a good corrosion resistance due to the formation of a compact oxide layer on its surface. That so it is generally used without using any painting, any anti-corrosion coating or inhibitor. In some environments, such as industrial areas or marine and coastal areas, the formation of this protective layer is obstructed and or retarded. So, despite its very good mechanical and structural properties, Corten cannot be used unpainted in some aggressive environments. So it needs to be treated with some inhibitors of or some anti-corrosion coatings. So the aim of our research work was to give a contribution for overcoming the restrictions connected to Corten application, and but also to investigate on new green and eco-friendly corrosion inhibitors in order to, with a perspective to replace the commercial corrosion inhibitors which revealed to be toxic for both human health and the environment. For this purpose, we investigate on some Sicilian plants extract, so with the notorious antioxidant activity. So in that case, we try to exploit also spontaneous plants from our territory. Well, I would like to spend just a few words about corrosion, wet corrosion. Wet corrosion is called also electrochemical corrosion, and it is, as the words say, an electrochemical process that occurs in the presence of water, so in aqueous solution, or when the relative humidity is higher than 60%. Of course, the corrosion process is more aggressive when there are many salts, when the concentration of salts dissolved in seawater, in water, for example, sodium chloride in seawater, are high because the conductivity of the solution is high. In the example you see, there is the corrosion of iron in acidic aerated aqueous solution. The iron sample presents both anodic and cathodic areas. In the anodic area, iron is oxidized to iron 2 plus, and 2 electrons are released. These electrons reach the cathodic site and they reduce oxygen. So what is the also the result of this process is the formation of rust, which is an hydrated iron oxide on the top of the sample. Well, as corrosion, wet corrosion is an electrochemical process, of course, electrochemical methods are very appropriate for studying, estimating, and predicting the severity of the process. The most popular and most used electrochemical techniques for the characterization of corrosion processes are electrochemical impedance spectroscopy and dynamic polarization. Well, electrochemical impedance spectroscopy is an advanced electrochemical method used for studying the processes occurring at the different interfaces. Each process is modeled by electrical elements, and by fitting electrochemical impedance spectra of metals or alloys in corrosive medium, it is possible to get an important electrical value, which is called the charge transfer resistance, which is used according to equation one for the calculation of the inhibition efficiency. Well, the other technique is the dynamic polarization. It is also used for studying the corrosion process, but the approach is different because dynamic polarization studies the kinetics of the corrosion process by means of the so-called Tafel plots, you can see from the slide. And by elaborating Tafel plots, we can get the value of corrosion current, which is employed according to equation two for the calculation of inhibition efficiency too. But dynamic polarization is useful for also for evaluating another important parameter, which is called the corrosion rate, which is used from by NACE International for having a qualitative ranking of the severity of corrosion. So in this table, you see that according to the corrosion rate, which is measured in millimeter per year, millimeters are the thickness of the sample, which are lost when the sample is exposed to aggressive media. So according to this value, the relative corrosion resistance of a material in a particular environment can be outstanding, excellent, good, fair, poor, or unacceptable. Well, the first step of our research work was the characterization of our extracts. The first extract is the bulbs extract of Brassica campestris. This is the chromatography. The chromatography evidenced the presence of 18 metabolites, mainly representative of flavonoids, sucrose, glucosinolates, hydroxy fatty acids, hydrocinnamic acid derivatives. The other extract is the bulbs extract of allium commutatum. The chromatogram shows that the most abundant compounds are sulfurate amino acids, sulfurate compounds, and flavonoids, with a predominance of alline and allicin. And the other two compounds we tested were the bulb extract of Allium subhirsutum and the flowers and stem extracts of the same plant. Also here we can see the presence of sulfurate amino acids, sulfurate compounds, and flavonoids, with a predominance of alline and allicin in the case of bulb extracts, and with the predominance of quercetin in the case of flower and stem extracts. Okay, this slide shows the comparison of the anti-corrosion activity of bulbs extracts of the two alliage. Electrochemical impedance spectra was recorded in absence and in presence of a different concentration of the inhibitor. And we can see that in absence of the inhibitor, the best fitting circuit evidenced the presence of two interfaces, which suggest the presence of an oxide layer on the Corten surface. And this hypothesis was confirmed by XPS analysis, so the surface analysis of our compound. Instead, in presence of the different concentrations of inhibitor in both cases, so for subhirsutum and commutatum, ACE, electrochemical impedance spectra, evidenced an additional interface due to the formation of an organic layer on the oxide surface. As the concentration of the extract increases, the value of the charge transfer resistance increases too. What we can see also is that bulk's extract of commutatum is more effective than subirsutum at the lower concentration we test, that was 100 ppm. In fact, they gave us a charge transfer resistance of 5.93 kiloohm centimeter square against 3.91 kiloohm centimeter square. But at 800 ppm, bulk extract of subirsutum result more effective than commutatum. By calculating the inhibition efficiency, alum subirsutum shows the best value, the best performance, which was 89%. These results were confirmed by dynamic polarization. First of all, we can see that both the extracts behave like anodic inhibitors, and at the lower concentration, the best performance was found in the case of bulk extract of commutatum with a corrosion current density of 21 microamp per centimeter square, which is lower than subirsutum bulk extract. But at the optimum concentration, subirsutum bulk extract were the best inhibitors, with an inhibition efficiency of 91.6%. The corresponding corrosion rate is 0.1 millimeter per year. So according to NACE International, this value suggests an excellent corrosion resistance. Instead, if we compare it with the corrosion rate in absence of the inhibitor, we have a poor corrosion inhibition. This slide instead shows extracts, the performance of extracts of different parts of the same plant. So we are referring to bulbs extract of subirsutum and flower and stems extracts of subirsutum. Also here we see that at lower concentration we have a best performance in the case of flower and stems extract with a charge transfer resistance of 5.2 kiloohm centimeter square against 3.91 kiloohm centimeter square. But in any case, the best performance is still calculated in the case of bulbs extract with inhibition efficiency of 89%. Also here, dynamic polarization confirms the data we found by electrochemical impedance spectroscopy. Also in this case, flower and stems extract behave like anodic inhibitors, and they have a better performance at the lower concentration of 100 ppm, but the best performance was found in the case of subirsutum bulbs extract at 800 ppm as optimum concentration with an inhibition efficiency of 91.6%. Let's see now what happens if we use Brassica campestris, in particular bulbs extracts of Brassica campestris for the protection of corten in acidic medium. Okay, we found that the best electrochemical impedance data revealed that the optimum concentration was 120 ppm, and that lower concentrations here not reported have catalytic effects toward the corten corrosion. In any case, the charge transfer resistance is very small if we compare it with the other bulbs extract we already see. And if we compare also the charge transfer resistance in presence of Brassica and in absence of Brassica, the difference is very small. The best fitting circuit evidenced both in both cases, so in absence and in presence of an inhibitor, two interfaces, and the best inhibition efficiency is of just 27 plus minus 4, so it is very small. Instead, Brassica extracts have a very good effect in protecting corten in sodium chloride, and the best, the optimum concentration was 80 ppm, and the corresponding inhibition efficiency was 82 plus minus 2. But what is interesting to notice also is that Brassica campestris is very effective in sodium chloride also at very low concentration. In fact, with the 15 ppm, we have already an inhibition efficiency of 73.8 plus minus 3. So it is a very performing compound for this inhibition. And the best circuit, the best fitting circuit evidenced the absence of oxide layer. And this, so it is just a simple randless circuit. So this result confirms that it is impossible for the oxide to form in presence of chlorides. And these data also gives us another information, because Brassica inhibits corrosion with a different mechanism with respect of the two alliage we saw before. But the mechanism of inhibition is also different if we consider acidic rain or seawater. The kinetics data confirm also the electrochemical impedance results. So the Brassica campestris bulk extracts behave like also anodic inhibitors of the corrosion. And the best performance was shown in sodium chloride by adding 80 ppm of the inhibitor with inhibition efficiency at of around 80%. The corresponding corrosion rate is 0.08 millimeter per year. So Brassica has an excellent anti-corrosion activity for corten in sodium chloride. And of course, if we consider the kinetics data in acidic solution, we see that the best performance was found in at 120 ppm, but the inhibition efficiency is very low. Well, these are three different inhibition mechanisms we can think, and that the hypothesis we do by electrochemical data are supported by XPS. So the different inhibitors act in different ways. For example, alliage in acidic solution behave like interface inhibitors because they form a homogeneous layer onto the sample surface. And this hypothesis was supported by XPS data. Instead, Brassica in acidic solution practically doesn't form any layer. And we saw also that the effect of Brassica is practically negligible. So we can say that the mechanism of inhibition is due to the formation of an amorphous ferric oxide hydroxide layer that dissolves and self-repair. Instead, in the case of Brassica in sodium chloride, we don't see any presence of oxide. And we can do the hypothesis that the inhibition mechanism is due to the formation of a metal organic complex, which is not evidenced by electrochemical impedance spectroscopy, but it was evidenced by XPS spectra. So in conclusion, we saw that different extracts of different plants have been used and compared as corrosion inhibitors for cortland steel in acidic media, aliace and brassicace, that by comparing a bulbs extract of different kinds of aliace sub hirsutum revealed to be more performing at 800 ppm with an inhibition efficiency of 90%, by comparing extracts of different parts of the same plant, we have performance in the case of steel of bulbs of sub hirsutum. And if we compare aliace and brassicace, we see that aliace are and still corrosion inhibitors. On the other hand, excellent corrosion inhibitors in salt at very low pressure, the best with the efficiency of 83%.